We've got back with us Yasha Levine, who is roving reporter for Pando Daily, formerly editor of The Exile, a great site as well, co-founder of The Shame Project, and author of The Corruption of Malcolm Gladwell. Yasha, thanks so much for coming back to see us.
Thanks for having me.
So listen, there are a couple things that caught my eye. I want to talk about what you've been digging into lately about Google, but there are a couple things that have caught my eye in the news with our friends at Google. Is beginning to make me think, by the way, of, if you ever watched Futurama, of Mom Corp or whatever it was called, but you know, they're just everywhere doing everything. But two things caught my eye. One was both in the Washington Post. One was a story saying that Google is now the second largest investor in lobbying of any corporation in Washington, D.C., and is a master of Washington influence. I guess they're feeling lucky. And number two is that Google worked behind the scenes with George Mason University to pack conferences with Google-friendly folks and hide that so that it appeared as if there was an academic consensus that, gosh, Google is just okay. So those were the two things. We can talk about that or anything else you want to talk. What have you been looking into about Google lately?
Well, you know, and it's good. Yeah, I'm glad that the Washington Post did those two great stories. You know, I've actually been looking and digging into some of the same things, and so I was familiar with a lot of what was reported. But I think they're great stories, you know, because I think there's a kind of a naive belief still that, you know, in Silicon Valley, a sort of liberal or progressive politics can coexist comfortably and peacefully with a kind of a techno-libertarianism, a kind of a some sort of lefty libertarian, techno-libertarianism. And what, you know, Google has shown really is that when these companies become so massive and become basically a monopolies in our economy, when push comes to shove, these companies will always go hard right and get in bed with, you know, the Koch brothers, which is what part of that story is about. Part of the Washington Post story is about the Google has been really getting really, really, really close, scarily close with the Koch team, with the Cato Institute, George Mason University, Heritage Foundation, Mercatus, all these outfits that were either set up by the Koch brothers or, you know, intimately involved with them and their machine, you know, Google is becoming a big partner for them, a big technology partner. So it's an important story, and I think it's a story that is difficult for it to get traction because I think there's some cognitive dissonance in people's minds because it's really hard for us, even for me, you know, who's a reporter and who looks at this stuff every day, to kind of come to terms with, wait, like, Google is with the Koch brothers? Like, what the fuck? What is going on?
We're going to have to bleep that. But, yeah. No, exactly. Yeah. I think that's why it's important to keep on this, because Google, as your great reporting has shown, has extraordinary amounts of data on every American. So, to me, I mean, first of all, yes, we get this sort of techno-hipster gloss we've talked about before where you think it's the cool guy getting the cappuccino and all of a sudden he morphs into, you know, Charles and David Koch or, you know, whatever symbol of a sort of strip mining corporate evil you want to think of. But so that in and of itself is frightening, but in many ways, you know, I'm curious your thoughts, but I think these guys are scarier. And the reason why I think they're scarier, no matter how many lattes they order, is that they've got the Koch brothers. They can ruin our forests and our grazing lands and our air. These guys can actually penetrate what's going on in our minds. I mean, am I being exaggerated about that?
Well, yeah, no, it's an unholy alliance. I agree. You know, it's hard to say which is worse. You know, for someone to know what you're thinking or for you to not have any drinking water. You know, you know, we can argue about this. I think you're bringing up a really good point. Like the fact that Google is now partnering. Google, the company's goal, explicit goal, is to mediate as much of our lives through its servers as possible. And so meaning that, you know, so that it can be the medium through which our thoughts and our life and our, you know, everything that we do in life, everything that we think, everything that we write, everything that we watch, everything that we read, everyone that we talk to and see, all our relationships are mediated and recorded and analyzed and mined for information so that they can better understand us and better target us with, you know, whatever their, you know, current money-making scheme is.
Right, and just so people
advertising tomorrow, it's whatever, you know.
Right,
yeah.
And just so people don't think I'm crazy, we're talking with Yasha Levine of Pando Daily about Google. Just so people don't think, obviously, we need to breathe air and drink water. But if once you acquire the power to know everything we think, and once, by the way, and we only got a minute left, so we'll have to have you back to talk about this. I think they're channeling people in different segments of reality so that people who don't want to hear a conversation like you and I are having are no longer exposed to it. I think these are various ways that they can prevent us from protecting our drinking water and protecting our air. And so that's why I think what you call an unholy alliance between the two is so deeply frightening. And I guess, you know, I'll give you the last 20 seconds or so to conclude.
Yeah, well, no, you make a very good point. When a company like this gets into politics, it's always dangerous. When a company knows intimate things about you and knows pretty much everything that knows your thoughts, when it starts getting into politics and starts getting into trying to sway the political process, you know, it's really disturbing. It's really disturbing. And you bring up a good point. So I think this is something that, you know, we're gonna see a lot more, I think, reporting on this. And I think there's, I have a feeling that when people start to understand that what Google's really up to, people are gonna switch on Google and they're gonna turn on Google. And when that happens, it's gonna be hard because it is scary, you know, as you point out.
All right. Well, we'll leave it there. And I know your reporting is gonna be a huge part of that, driving that conversation. So Yasha Levine, Pando Daily, thanks so much for being with us.